Well, howdy, howdy, folks. I am glad you're here, and I wanna cover something that will help you gather catering gigs or any gig, okay? Private event stuff, anything you want to do where you need to collect information, but you don't want to answer the phone all the freaking time, right? So, I have shared this before with the Vendors United Group, but I'm also broadcasting there right now. Should be working, hopefully it is, at both places, because I wanted to go through some of the basics on using Google Forms. And you may have never heard of this, and you may use AOL for your email or Yahoo. Well, here's what I can tell you. It's free to get a Gmail, okay? Get you one. Okay, you don't have to download anything. You don't have to do nothing. You just log in and set up a username and password, and now you got a Gmail, right? Well, because you're now a Gmail customer, there's a lot of benefits, but one of the big benefits is using their Google Forms. If you notice, if you go to Google, I'm sure you've used Google. You go right up here to the top and see where it says Google Forms right there. You just type in Google Forms, just like I did. And what you'll be given is a page. Well, let me go to this page first. I'm gonna show you what this looks like. Okay, you'll be given a page like this. That's what your page will look like. And on this page, if you are not a Gmail subscriber yet, you'll want to be one before you get to this page, because you need to put in your Gmail email address. That's how they verify you. So, and this is a free service. You won't get spam emails. You won't even get sales pitch emails. You'll get nothing. Okay. So, you just click on Go to Google Forms, right? And that's going to open up when you log in. It'll take you to a login screen, and you'll put your new Gmail address or your existing one, and then you will put your password, same password you used for your email. And that will open up Google Forms. Google Forms up here at the top, I want you to see right up here at the top, you should be able to see my mouse cursor moving around. You see this says start a new form blank or a contact. They have pre-filled out forms for you. Contact information, RSVP, party invite, t-shirt sign up, event gallery, and look at this right here. They got tons of stuff like event feedback, order forms, job application, time off request. Let's say you're needing somebody to help you on your cart and you want to put a Craigslist ad. You could have it go to a job application form where they fill it out, it gets emailed to you, and you don't have to deal with anything. You don't have to wait for them to scan, or you don't have to ask them questions. All the questions are there. So there's lots of features here. You can do quizzes, you can do all kinds of stuff. I'm not here to teach you any of that right now. So what I want to tell you about is the blank stuff, just setting up a blank one. But I want to show you what this looks like when you're done. This is my daughter, one of my seven, my youngest of seven, Kaylee. She is starting to, she got her a pig roaster pro, okay, from roastingnomad.com, roastingnomad.com, there's a plug, okay? And she is going to be doing this. Well, she posted on Facebook, and people just go that she put this link when they asked a commenter on it. She put this link. It's got a video. It's got all kinds of stuff, and it asks them questions for what they're looking for. How many people are you wanting to serve? Are you wanting sides and dry goods? How soon are you wanting to schedule? Name, email, address where you'd like us to be. Some of these, the ones with the red asterisks, they have to fill out, or it won't let them finish. This, like address, they may not want to give you that yet. They may want a price first. Best time to contact you, morning, afternoon, evening, or other. How would you like me to contact you? Phone or email? Comments, your answer. Okay, so if they have a specific need that you didn't cover in your questions, they may want to type it in there. They would hit next, and that gets emailed to you immediately, and it saves it. Okay, I'll show you how this works. If you go to, let me see if I can find one. I'm going to go back a page here. Bear with me. Okay, here's my daughter Kaylee's I helped her create this. Here's the responses. And these are just the last three responses. Every time we get responses, we delete them after we contact them. Okay? Because there's no reason to keep them. Right? So this tells you everything they're wanting. It gives you a bar graph, tells you their answers, their email, their phone number, everything about them, right? And then all you have to do is click this button and hit delete all responses, which we have already contacted these people, so we're good, right? So you delete it and you let it keep going. And you can turn off responses. Let's say you don't want to run the program anymore. You can just turn it off just by hitting accepting or not accepting. Simple, right? We've already had to turn ours off because we got too many requests at one time. Or she got too many requests. So that's all there is to it. And let's say while I'm here, this is in the dashboard. Now, this is what they would see. This is what I would see. And in here, I could go in here and change anything right now and it updates it. So I could put right here, hi. Sunshine, like this, right? And that updated. I don't have to hit enter or anything, right? I can go right to here and refresh this page. That's what the customer sees. And you see this? Hi, sunshine. So it takes nothing to update one of these forms. The only reason I wanted to show you this is to show you how quick and easy this is. But this isn't the point of me being on here. The point is to show you how to create one of these quickly and easily, without any trouble, so that while you sleep, you could be getting catering jobs. You could be getting questions about, hey, can I rent your cart? Okay? Can I rent your pig roaster? Can I rent your cart? Can I rent your food truck? Can you do a drop-off? Can you be here this Sunday? That kind of stuff. So you have to determine your questions and stuff to make that happen. So what I would do is we're back over here and I'm going to go, let's see, I'm going to go back one so I can take you back to the blank. So here's how easy this is. I started with a blank form. Now I could have used this form right here. Could have used, this one says contact information. It already has a lot of it pre-filled out and you can change anything you want. Okay, you can even move it around. But I'm going to start with a blank one. Okay, so here we are with a blank form. And these are your questions. You don't even need to hit responses because you have none right now. So questions. And then you want to name it. So I'm going to call this Hillbilly Catering. And then form description is so that when your customer arrives, they know what you're doing. Fill this in and we'll get back to you soon with a quote. Okay, so if you wanted, that's as simple as it gets, right? So you could come here to the first question, and if you wanted this to be a multiple choice, you can, it's right here. If you wanted it to be a short answer, like a short answer would be something like, what's your name? First name. Okay, short answer text goes in. Now, you can make it required or not required. So I'm going to make it required because I'll need to know their name when I call them. I need to know, am I asking for Bob or am I asking for Susie, right? Now I want to add another question. I just click the plus button and add another question. But what if I want to add a picture? I can do that. What if I just want to add another, like a blip it of information? Let's say I want rules of the game. Okay? But that wouldn't work for catering, but what I could say is, I could say the catering basics. Okay? This isn't a question, but it's inside the questions, and it tells them all about my catering business. Right? Then, I could add another question. So I could come down here and go, best way to contact you. Okay? I would normally just put, what's your email? Okay? And then short answer. And hit required. And then I would put, My next one, I would put my next one as phone number. Oops, phone number. Now, at any point you're doing this, you can go right up here to preview and preview it. Here's the preview of this one so far. Okay? That's what the customer would see. That's it. So on this, I want to know, I want to put in a picture, or I want to do something like that. So I can even put in a video. If you noticed on my daughter, she has a video. So if you want to go there, I'm going to give you this real quick, obxpig.com. Okay? That opens up. What we did is we bought her a domain name. We didn't set up a website. We just made the domain name go directly to this Google form. Now, we can make it go wherever we want. It could have gone to a Facebook page, but we made it go to this Google form. That way, when somebody, she puts on her little flyer, you know, or she goes out and talks to somebody, she can go, oh, just go to obxpig.com, all the information's there. Well, not all the information's here. Now, she could add information in here if she wanted, right? But she doesn't have to. She can just have that simple page, doesn't cost anything. That's the beauty of this. So at 2 o'clock in the morning, somebody finds out they've got 1,100 people coming in for a family reunion, and the family reunion got rescheduled to their place, and what are we going to do? I just saw this on Facebook. Crazy Dogs does catering. Well, now they can just go and book themselves at 2 o'clock. Now, you can do all kinds of stuff. You can make it auto-book. You can set up a calendar with Google Calendar. I don't do any of that stuff. I just do the basics. So what happens is this sends it to me, right? And then I don't have to worry about anything. So this is the basic gist of it. If we wanted to add an image, we'd click this. If we wanted a video, we'd click this. If we wanted another section, we could do another section to it. That way we broke the page up. Let me show you what this looks like. Look here. Now we'll just view this, okay? And see, we created a, another, let's see, did I do that right? Look here, test. And then I'm gonna look at this one and see. Okay, there we go. So, Hillbilly Catering, first name. Okay, I don't know why that didn't show up, but I'm checking to make sure. I'm going to take this one off. I may have pulled up too many. So, then I could go add a question. Who you is, right? And let me hit preview on this. Oh, it's on next. It's the next section. So it won't let me go to the next section until I answer these questions. So let's just do this. Tom, and then blah, 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 and then next. And then look, that's our next section. So you can set it up in sections where it's easy so they don't see this long form. You could have each question or every two questions in a section. It makes this so easy, and you can have fun with this because you can put big backsplashes on it. You can do all kinds of stuff. I can go right in here right now. Let me pull this off. I can go in here right now and I can put in a background. There are so many cool things. And let's just say you want to do something unique, like you want this to go to an Excel file or a Google Documents, like a document file so you save everybody. You can do that. You can go right here to add-ons, see this crazy puzzle piece, click it, and it pulls up all these available add-ons. You can do email notifications, form notifications, you can do all kinds of stuff. If you don't have that add-on button, click the three dots right here and click add-ons, and that will add them. Okay, look, here's what it's going to pull up for me. And it's got all these different add-ons, things that you might use. Like what I like to do is click all right here and go, okay, I need to know some business tools. Okay, here's Smart Bookkeeper, form to email. They even have a form that sends the customer an invoice. So it actually turns your form into an invoice based on their questions. Now, I don't mess with that fancy stuff. I like to look at what they booked, right? I like to look at what they and how they answered, and then call them with a price or email them with a price. And I even ask them my forms, would you like text, email, or phone? Because people sometimes don't want to be bothered and they just want to get a quote. And it's cool that they can go, oh yeah, just text me or just email me. And you just email them and go, hey, John, thanks for filling out the form. We did you an awesome quote. It's going to be $642. That'll cover everybody. That comes out to about $8.55 a head. We'll be there for about 2 hours like you requested. Blah, blah, blah. Or, hey, John, we'll be there with the cart. We're going to drop it off. Here's the video link where you can do it if you want to book it. Everything's there for you. This stuff is amazing if you use it. You just have to, you have to play with it. And here's the nice part. You get done and some customer goes, you don't ask this. You can change it in seconds. Literally, you can change it in seconds. So I've got the add-on screen up right now. So let's say the customer goes, well, you didn't even ask for my email. Well, here's what you can do. You can go in here this quick and have an email. So I go up here and I go add a question. Email, short answer, and then you're done. Required. Okay? That's it. So then, what if you want a customer to have to fill in an email so that you get everything? Do you see this right here? Here's what I did. I clicked the three dots. I clicked preferences. It pulls up this box, right? And I hit collect email addresses. Okay? I don't need a default quiz. Okay? And then hit save. What this will do at the top of this form, it's going to ask them for their email and it'll say this form is collecting emails. Look, fill in this. We'll get back to you soon with a quote. Okay? Email, first name. What is your email? Now, that's because I was just testing it and so I was playing with it, so it gave you a lot of them. Twice. But that gives you an idea. I hope that helps you. I hope that helps you go, you know what? I like this. I think this will work for me. And this is a way to gather catering gigs. Now, I want to share one other tip with you real quick. You can gather gigs quickly by, I'm going to take a sip of my coffee, by posting up on Facebook groups in your area or letting someone else do it for you. Let's say you have a picture of you at your cart. You have a friend take that picture and post it up to a local Facebook group in your area. If you don't know how to do that, it's real simple. Go to Facebook, go up to the search box in Facebook, and type in your town. And then immediately, it's going to pull up all kinds of stuff. And then there's a tab up there that says groups. Click groups. That's all the groups available in your town. Some of them you have to ask for permission to be in, and some of them are just open groups. Join those groups. Be a part of those groups. Community groups, Mommy's Phoenix, Arizona group, whatever it is. And look at the numbers. How many people are in there? Oh, this one has 20 people in there. Don't worry about it. Don't even mess with that group. They got 6,000 in there. Yeah, that's a good group. The yard sale groups with 34,000 or 200 million or whatever it is. Join those groups. Then have a friend post up that picture you took that says, look what my crazy friend's doing. He's doing drop-off catering. You can rent this commercial mobile kitchen for your next event, for your next party, for the birthday party. Sick of cleaning the kitchen? Rent ours. I mean, all kinds of ways to get extra business that you never would have dreamed of. Most people get a hot dog cart and they think, man, I got to go find a street corner now and sell hot dogs. No. Most of the vendors in Vendors United, the street food pro team, they're not doing that. Most of them. Now, some of them do a little of both, right? They do a little of both, which is smart because over here, they're picking up new clients for over here and vice versa. It's a phenomenal business. Phenomenal business. I hope that helped you. I hope you enjoy that. And